गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई या वैशाली मैम वेलकम यू वंस अगेन इन एलकेमी ऑनलाइन ट्यूटोरियल्स क्लास टू सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन द रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 and 2, राइट? सो नाउ टुडे वी आर मूविंग फर्दर टू द चैप्टर नंबर 3। एज वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द रिवीजन ऑल्सो एंड योर वीकली टेस्ट ऑल्सो डन फॉर द चैप्टर नंबर 1 and 2, नाउ वी आर मूविंग फर्दर टू द चैप्टर नंबर 3 विच इज एडिशन। And chapter number 3 addition, I have taken the two session of chapter number 3 addition. Okay, so now I am moving further for the new concept, new content of chapter number 3 addition. So come, let's understand the rules of addition. Now, as we have completed the revision and your weekly test is also done for the maths, as we are moving to the chapter number 3 which is addition, till then I have taken the 3 to 4 sessions of the additions. Now moving further, we will take a quick recap of the addition. In the chapter number 3, it is divided into these 3 steps. So first of all, addition without regrouping and addition with regrouping. Okay. Now we will see the concept of addition without regrouping means what. Sum number 1, tens and ones, 3 plus 2. Okay, so this is the example of addition without regrouping means what, when we are doing the addition of single digit. 3 plus 2, this is known as addend. A-double-D-E-N-D, addend. These both are the addend and this is known as 3 plus 2 is 5. This is known as sum. S-U-M, sum. Okay. Now addition with regrouping means what? Now see here, whenever I have written 3 and 2, addition with regrouping means what? There is a sum of carryover. So 5 plus 6. So which you will do, the answer came. Answer will come 11, 1, upside 1, so we will write 11, we will write the answer 11 on the both the side in this way. Now these are the two addends, okay, here you can see the two addends. Now we will do the sum of 3 addends. Like 3 plus 5 plus 4. This is for just for your understanding. 3 plus 5 plus 4 means 3 in your mind, 5 on your finger, which makes 8. Okay, and 8 plus 4. So you, now you have to keep 8 in your mind, 4 on your fingers. So 8 plus 4 is 12. So these are the sums of one digit, addition without regrouping and addition with regrouping. Here we have taken the single digit number, but the answer came both the side, at the tens place also, at the ones place also. So these both are the example of addition with regrouping. Now moving to the next topic, which is addition of two digit numbers. This we have already done in the last first standard. Now we are in the second standard also. I have taken a video upon it. Now I am recalling it once again for you. So addition of two digit numbers. Now see example of addition of two digit number. Tens, ones, now 24 plus 21. Okay, so these are the example of two digit
without regrouping. 4 plus 1 is 5, 2 plus 2 is 4. Okay, so there is no carryover. So this is the addition of 2 digit number without regrouping. Now moving forward again, we will see the topic which is addition by regrouping once. Till the here you have learned in the first standard addition of regrouping once, but the second topic which is of addition by regrouping one sentence, which you have not learned in the first standard, we will learn in the second standard. So now here addition with regrouping once. So I will leave one box for this. 9, 2, 3, and 4. Suppose this is my number 39 plus 42. Okay, so now 9 in your mind, 2 on your finger. So what you will do after 9, 10, 11? So forward number up, backward number down. 3 plus 1 is 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. So the answer is 81. Okay. Now moving to the next sum. This is the example of addition without addition with regrouping once, only one side. Now we will do the addition of where. Now we will do the addition by the regrouping ones and tens. So here when we are doing the addition of ones and tens, you have to write, we will write HTO. Okay, 100 tens and ones. I will write the number 83 plus 29. 83 plus 29. So now 3 in your 9, bigger number is 9, so we will take 9 in my mind and 3 on my fingers. After 9, 10, 11 and 12. So answer is 12. Forward number up, backward number is down. Now 8 in your mind, 2 on your fingers. After 8, 9 and 10 and plus 1, 11. So forward number up, backward number down. So we will keep this one also down, as there is no number at the 100 place. So my answer is 102. Okay, so on this base, addition of tens and ones, addition by regrouping of tens and ones, you can see when we add this both, we have writing once this carry over, and when we are adding this both, at that time we are writing tens carry over. So that is why the name of this sums are addition by regrouping one sentence. We will do some more examples of this addition by regrouping of ones and tens. Now this both are the two examples of addition by ones and tens. Okay, so here you can see 100 tens and ones I have written. Number is 99 plus 33. 9 plus 3. 9 in your mind, 3 on your fingers. After 9, 10, 11, 12. So the answer we will write is 12. Forward number up, backward number down. Again 9 plus 3. Yes, this one is to 12. Plus 1, 13. So again forward number up, backward number down. Now as there is no number at 100 place, we will put this one down. So the answer is 132. Now the second example, 67 plus 54. 7 in your mind, 4 on your fingers. After 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Forward number up, backward number down. 6 plus 5, 6 in your mind, 5 on your fingers. After 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And 11 plus 1 is 12. So forward number up, backward number down. So the number, there is no number at one's place. So I will write here 1. So my answer is 121. So till now, as I will give you some homework, but not now as you are having your weekly test. So I will give you in the next class after your weekly test. So till then, today we have done this. Now in the same way, we will do the 3 digit, 3 addends, 1 addend, 2 addend and 3 addends in the next class. So I hope the concept should be clear for this.
I hope you have understood the concept of addition of chapter number 3, and I am not giving you any homework because you are having your weekly test of other subjects also. So be prepared for it. Okay, students, thank you.